purpose, we need to calculate the heat produced in that waterfall. What is how much heat produced? What is the formula for calculation of heat produced here? Mc delta T. Okay. So work done in terms of joule, we written as work done equal to J into H. So heat in the form of work, right? So now we need to equate the both equations. Mgh is equal to J M C delta T. Now delta T becomes what? Mm will cancel. Gh by Jc. Gh by Jc. Now calculate the delta T here. So what is the G value? 10. Height 210 meters. And J is the joules. That means constant value 4200. And C is 1. Okay, now calculate delta T here, that equal to 0.5 degree Celsius. That means option number A is the right answer. These are all 0.5 degree, 1 degree, 1.5 degree, 2 degree Celsius. Okay, so option number A is the right answer. Coming to second question, two samples of a gas at room temperature and atmospheric pressure and compressed to reduce their volumes to half. The first is compressed isothermally, whereas second is compressed adiabatically. The final pressure is unknown. Okay. First is greater than second, and second option is second is greater than first, and both is same. Both does not change. See here, for isothermal compression, I think you are all very well known about this formula. So now R is equal to PV by T, right? Right? So that means this R equal to PV by 2 for what? For 1 mole of gas. For 1 mole of gas. Okay. So now calculate the dimensional formula here. Pressure. So L power 1, M power 1, T square, L cube divided by Kelvin's mole unit. Kelvin's mole power 1. So it becomes M1. Okay. L power minus 1 here. That means it becomes L2, M power 1, T power 2, K power minus 1 and mole power minus 1. Okay. See the option here. M L square T square, that means T power minus 2, K power minus 1, mole power minus 1. M L square, see the options. What is the option here? See the options, that is D is the Right answer. M L square T power minus 2 K power minus 1 M power minus. So the universal gas constant like a dimensional formula is M L square T power minus 2 K power minus 1 mole power minus. Okay. Next question. Sudden compression of trigonometric gas. Sudden compression of trigonometric gas to 1/8 of its volume will increase its pressure. That means what? A sudden compression occurs in a adiabatic process. That means adiabatic change. So in adiabatic process, PV power R equal to constant, right? Now P2 by P1 is equal to V1 by V2 whole power R. So for triangular glass, they given R equal to 4 by 3. For triangular gas, R equal to 4 by 3. Therefore, P2 equal to V1 by 8 whole power 4 by 3. So it becomes P1 is equal to 2 cube whole power 4 by 3. That is equal to P1 is equal to 2 power 4. So it becomes 16 times of P1. 16 times. That means option number C is the right answer. Tuning fork of frequency 480 Hz can produce 5 beats with fork of frequency. So this is very basic knowledge question. What is the beat frequency formula? Beat frequency B is equal to N1 minus N2. That means 480 minus 475. That becomes 5. That means option number D is the right answer. Next. A step down transform will step down the voltage, resistance, current and power. A transformer is used to set up or set down for voltage itself. Keep this point. Remember this point. When a transformer is used to set up or set down voltage only. Okay. Next. Six inductors, each of inductance 1.5H are connected in series. The effective inductance in the combination is effective induction of series of combination of inductance here. L is equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus and so on. In case of N equal inductance, that equal to L is equal to N into L. That means 6 into 1.5. How much? It becomes 9H. Okay. Option number C is the right answer. Coming to next question. The unit of power of an engine. Unit of power of an engine. Option A. Kilowatt hour, diopter, horsepower, Fermi. Horsepower is the FPS unit of power community. That means power of engines are expressed in kilowatt hour. Next, velocity of sound in gas V is equal to root RP by D, where P is the pressure and D is the density of the gas. The dimensions constant R is equal to, by squaring on both sides, R equal to what will we get? V square D by P. Okay. Now write down the dimensionless formula for velocity. Velocity equal to meter per second square. That means L T power minus 1 whole square into D. Density L cube M power 1 by L power minus 3, right? Kg per meter cube. Next, power M L T power minus 2. Now what will you get? L0 M0 T0. So that means R is the constant. So constant doesn't have any dimensionless formula. Okay. Next, the magnitude of vector A equal to, see the vector here, A equal to root 2i plus 3j plus 5k. Calculate the magnitude. Mod A is equal to how much? Square root of 2 plus 9 plus 25. So it becomes root 36, that is equal to 6. So option number B is the right answer. Next, vector ABC such that A dot B equal to 0, A dot C equal to 0. They given A bar dot B bar is equal to 0. That implies A bar is perpendicular to B bar. Next, A bar dot C bar is equal to 0. That implies A bar is perpendicular to C bar. Now we know that A bar dot C bar will be perpendicular to both B bar and C bar. Then A bar is perpendicular to both B bar and C bar. Therefore, A bar is parallel to B bar and C bar. B bar dot C bar. So that means option number D is the right answer. The resultant of two vectors will be having maximum magnitude when angle between them is. The resultant of two vectors having maximum magnitude. Resultant between them, that means angle between them. So when theta is equal to 0, what is cos theta equal to 1? Then what is the resultant formula we have? R is equal to P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. So this becomes, cos theta becomes 1. That means that it can be written as P square plus Q square plus 2PQ. So it is in the form of A plus B whole square, right? Now it can be written as P plus Q whole square. Square root will cancel. Then R is equal to P plus Q. This is the maximum magnitude. P plus Q is the maximum magnitude. Okay. So therefore the option is angle between them is 0. So option A is the right answer. Coming to next question. The range of projectile is maximum when projected at 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees. What is the range formula? R is equal to U square sine 2 theta by G, right? So it is maximum when sine 2 theta is maximum. That means 2 theta is equal to 90 degrees. Theta becomes 45 degrees. At that time it will be maximum. So option B is the right answer. At maximum height, the ratio of kinematic and projectile energies of projectile thrown at 45 degrees with the horizontal is. At maximum height, vertical component U sin theta is equal to 0 and only horizontal component, that means U cos theta only exist. Okay. Hence kinetic energy is equal to, what is the basic formula for kinetic energy? Half M U square. That means we need to substitute that horizontal component here. That means U square cos square theta. Okay. So what is the potential energy formula? MgH. What is the maximum height formula? Mg into U square sine 2 theta by G. Okay. That equal to half M U square, half M U square sine square theta. Therefore, kinetic energy is to potential energy is equal to. So what it becomes? Cos square is to sin square. That becomes 1:1. So option A is the right answer. Okay. The distance traveled by a freely falling body in the first, second and third are in the ratio of distance traveled by a freely falling body during nth second. That formula for nth second is dn is equal to dn is equal to g into n minus 1 by 2. Here they given d1 is to d2 is to d3 equal to 1 by 2 is to 1 by 5 is to 1 by, sorry, 5 by 2 is to 5 by 2. So it becomes 1:3:5. 1:3:5. Okay. So option number B is the right answer. A good lubricant must be Good lubricant must be high viscous liquid, reduce the friction, and low volatility, keep it longer duration. So a good lubricant must be options: high viscous, low viscous, volatile, highly viscous, and volatile. That means option number D is the right answer. A cube of 2 kg mass rest on rough inclined plane of slope 3 in 5. If coefficient of friction is 0.5, the maximum force necessary to move it up the plane g equal to 10 meter per second square. Yeah, so see that here, what is the formula for this force? F equal to mg into sin theta plus cos theta whole power 4. Just substitute the values. 2 kgs into g value is 10. Sin theta is 3/5. Cos theta is, what is the cos theta value here? 2/5. So it becomes 20 kilonewtons. 20 newtons. Okay. This is the diagram. Here they given 4, 3, and it becomes 5. Right. So from that we can write down the values. So option number 20 newtons is the right answer. Two balls, one of iron and other wood, having same velocity, are dropped from a tower simultaneously. When they are 1 meter above the ground, they have equal minimum potential energy and kinetic energy depends on the mass. Potential energy, kinetic energy, both are depends on the mass, which are not equal. Hence, none of the answer. Okay, none of the above is the answer. Half meter scale fixed at one end is rotated through 60 degrees. The increase in its potential energy is, so here h is equal to, they given l into 1 minus cos theta. So from that, what is the h? They given 0.5, half meter. 1 minus cos theta, cos 60 is 1/2. So it becomes 0.25 meter. Now calculate the increase in potential energy. Increase in potential energy is equal to mgh. That equal to, so 1 kg 10 into height is 0.25. Then it becomes 2.5 joules. So option number A is the right answer. So these are the some best important questions we prepared in physics. So which are very much useful for your recent examinations. So all of you go through this video once. And if you have any doubts and any suggestions you need to give, please comment us in the below video. We'll reply you. So all of you go through my videos. If you think these videos are very useful or helpful for your preparation, please do like my videos and share with your friends and subscribe my channel. After subscription, don't forget to tap on the bell icon for more updates. Thank you. Thank you for watching.